boom. That's a large explosion. What you are looking at are the initial stages of the single largest explosive volcanic eruption to have occurred so far in 2025. This eruption began when, at 11:05 a.m. local time earlier today, the Laki-Laki cone of Indonesia's Lewotobi volcano violently erupted, sending a mushroom-shaped sustained plume of ash upwards, which eventually reached an altitude of 22,200 meters or 72,835 feet. The heavier material in this plume was unable to rise and thus collapsed back to the ground and behaving much like an avalanche in snow except involving superheated gas currents lethal to anything it touches, it generated a series of long-reaching pyroclastic flows. You can even see that the initial more gas-rich pyroclastic surge nearly traveled up to the rim of the neighboring Perempuan cone, meaning it climbed up 1,237 feet of the mountain in only a few seconds. As sirens wailed, abundant volcanic lightning was generated, and the aforementioned pyroclastic flows moved downslope at speeds of up to 120.1 miles per hour or 193.3 kilometers per hour. While this is occurring, strong westerly blowing winds in the stratosphere cause the day to seemingly become a very hazy twilight for those to the west of the volcano on Flores Island. Then, hundreds of thousands of gas-rich volcanic rock fragments carried high into the plume began raining down on multiple towns up to 13 kilometers away, with some more than softball-sized fragments coating the ground. At least one person was injured by these falling fragments, but allegedly this individual is currently in good condition. The eruption continued for another 2 full hours, and by the time it had ended, nearly 21 square kilometers or 8.1 square miles surrounding the volcano had been incinerated, with pyroclastic flows traveling up to 5,600 meters away from Laki-Laki's summit. However, this attempt at geolocating the extent of destruction is still preliminary, and there is a chance my figure could be an overestimate for the pyroclastic flow extent by a factor of 2. However, what is for sure is that today's eruption of Lewotobi dwarfs not only every other major eruption it produced since November 2024 began, but also marks this volcano's largest eruption on record. Just look at how the eruption plume heights compare. While all 5 of those prior eruptions were also sustained, they were merely sub-plinian, but today's eruption was a true plinian eruption due to the more than 20 kilometer high eruption plume which was generated. This was the same type of eruption plume Mount St. Helens produced in 1980, only occurring during the most energetic of explosive volcanic eruptions. I personally estimate that 105 million cubic meters of tephra was ejected, meaning we could assign today's eruption a volcanic explosivity index of a very low 4. And yet, today's eruption wasn't over yet. As a plug that had formed 2 hours before the plinian eruption seemingly reformed at 3:30 p.m., causing immense pressure and volatiles to build up once again. This occurred until the pressure was sufficient to break upwards through the overlying rock and debris, generating another large explosion, this time a subplinian eruption with a 50,000 foot or 15.2 kilometer high plume. Once again, the sustained activity continued for a full 2 hours before ceasing. It is still somewhat uncertain why Lewotobi's eruptions have become unusually explosive since November of last year, involving now 6 major eruptions, but I speculate that both a temporarily increased magma supply and unusually gas-rich magma are to blame. During that time span, major eruptions have repeatedly occurred during cyclical activity right after a lava dome sufficiently expanded in size to form an effective plug. In other words, there is no reason to expect that a 7th major eruption of Lewotobi won't occur later this year if this process continues. However, there is one thing to be thankful for. Today's eruption, unlike the prior 2 subplinian Lewotobi events earlier this year, did not appear to have resulted in any fatalities and did not shell nearby towns with large blocks of rock like what occurred in November of last year. Stay tuned for more updates and stay safe. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's supporters via our YouTube members and patrons on Patreon.